most people who get into metaphysics and spirituality, they get to a certain point where they start to feel bad about whatever, wars, cancer, arguments in families. I'm doing this to myself. The secret of salvation is but this, you are doing this to yourself. He's talking about the dynamic of it's just your mind and your thoughts. And as long as you're identified with those judgments and attack thoughts, you seem to be doing it to yourself. That's not God's will. As Maria said, God's will is for joy. God's will is for happiness. You know, you've got to live your happy. But you aren't going to live your happy if you stay identified with attack thoughts and with judgments. Jesus taught us in the Sermon on the Mount, judge not. So, when she was talking to me, she said, how do you address that, David? How does the Course in Miracles address this responsibility question? And I said, well, the most important line for me in the Course was Jesus telling me you are not responsible for the error. You are responsible for accepting the correction for the error. Wow. There's some true responsibility. That'll take you back to divine innocence. So all this shadow work that we're talking about, all this raising the darkness to the light, all this bringing illusions to the truth, is only for one point where you can align with your internal teacher and accept your divine nature. Hop off the wheel of processing. Hop off the wheel of the steps of forgiveness and go for atonement, which literally lifts you and carries you with the Holy Spirit and Jesus' help into a place of perfect innocence where you can honestly feel in your heart, I've never done anything wrong ever, or right. Isn't that nice, that last part? You've never done anything wrong or right because you're not the doer. The doer is a body. We've just been convinced that behaviors are who we are. It's not the truth. Before Abraham was, I am. Before Jesus and the apostles, I am. Before history was, I am. Yeah, try that one on. For yourself, take it in. Before history was, I am. That's why there's two parts in the Course where Jesus says, forgive me your illusions. What do you think he's talking about? Except forgive history. Forgive the man. Forgive the behaviors. Forgive everything. Forgive the crucifixion, forgive the seeming resurrection, rolling away the stone. Forgive all the images. Have no graven images before the Lord thy God. Wow, we're starting to really get a sense of what that means. Hold no graven images, hold no appearances before the Lord thy God.